Hey, what up? It's Will Maker. Today, I'm going to go over Ableton's drum rack. I'm going to go over things like layering, how to add effects, how to export tracks individually, and the basics of setting up a macro. So with that, let's go ahead and dive in. The drum rack is one of my favorite features in Ableton, and more than anything, drums can make or break a track. So the first thing that I'm going to do is go over layering. I'm going to start by adding a blank drum rack. So I'm going to add a kick, snare, hat, and an open hat. So I'll play the kick again. Now that kick doesn't have very much bottom end. So say for instance I want to layer another kick. I'll choose this one. Now you could just duplicate a track and replace the sound and copy the MIDI. Or what I can do is I can hold command and I can drag this into my kick. Now when I open this, we've noticed that it creates an instrument track. It keeps both sounds in here, and now it's really easy to layer. So now I could just take some of the low end out of the original kick, keep some of the top character, add another EQ, and take the top end out of this one. Before and after. This is an easy way to layer sounds, and it allows you to still process each track as you see fit. Next thing I'm going to go over is a choke group. Now, I mainly use a choke group when I have an open hi-hat. So when you don't want a certain group of sounds to overlap and you want the sound to cut off when you use another sound, just use a choke group. So what you're going to do is you're going to click here and click here so your input and output section is showing. And now I'm going to make sure that they're in the same group. Here's the example without the choke group. And here's with the choke group. It's a nice and easy way to use open hi-hats. Next, I'm going to show you ways that you can add effects to your drum rack. First, make sure that your chain list is showing. So same steps here. Now I'm going to add a return track. Now we're just going to drop our effect right in here. Now you're just going to come over here and adjust your send. The second way is if you want to use your effect sends that you have outside of your drum rack right here. Same process, you need to make sure the input output section is showing. You're going to come right down here and you're going to right click and create a return chain. Come over here to audio 2. And then you're going to select the effect that you want to add in your chain. Now we can just come over to the send. And if you notice, this is B. So we're going to come over here to B. And now we can turn up the send. The last way that I use effects also helps me with the setup to export my tracks individually. This helps if I want to use another DAW for mixing or if I want to send my tracks to collaborators. First, I need to create audio tracks. So I'll name these. To route my tracks, I'm going to start with audio from. So I'm going to come down here to drum rack. I'm going to select my kick pre-effects. Same with my snare. I'm going to put my hats in a group so I can select my hats together. Next, I'm going to make sure monitor in is selected. Next, I'm going to want to mute the drum rack here, otherwise both sounds will be playing at once. Now I can just add my effects as I choose. Now when I render, I have two options. So I can come to File, Export. I can choose all individual tracks. Now, if I want my effects baked into my samples, in other words, effects applied to my samples, then I need to turn on Include, Return, and Master. So now if I play my snare, the reverb is on my snare. Otherwise, I can choose all individual tracks and leave off include return and master effects. Now my snare is dry, but I have a separate reverb track now. Lastly, I'll touch on macros. A macro is a knob that allows you to map any parameter within a chain. As an example, I'm going to take this reverb and a filter. I'm going to group them together. Just hold shift and highlight both of them, and you can either group them right here or you could use the shortcut Command G. Now I'm going to come over here and show hide macro controls. I'm going to use decay with this option, so I'm going to right click and I'm going to map this to macro 1. For third-party plugins, click here, click configure, and now I can right click and assign my macro. And now we have an effect that sounds like this. Another thing you can do is you can come over here and select map, and you can do a minimum and maximum. Macros can also be automated as well. Another things macros let you do is cycle up to 128 sounds. So for instance, I have a new session here. I'm going to click on drum rack. I'm going to drag an empty sampler right in here. Come over here to my selection of kicks. I'm just going to highlight this entire row by holding shift and clicking. Drag these in, click on zone, select, right click, distribute ranges equally, right click again, and I'm going to map this to macro 1. Now if I play my kick, this can also be really useful in a live performance. So those are some useful ways that I use the drum rack in Ableton. So for more content like this, please feel free and like and subscribe. Other than that, peace out.